Well, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Strawberry Fields. What a glorious day we've been given, hey? I've been praying hard for sunshine, and so far we have it. It's lovely to see you all, such a good crowd that have come out. My name is Major Kathy Fassfeldt, and I have the wonderful privilege of leading the work here at Strawberry Field. We are privileged today to have all of you joining us, but we have a number of dignitaries that I'd like to welcome by name. We have the Vice Lord Lieutenant of Merseyside, Robert Owen, welcome. We have the High Sheriff of Merseyside, her first visit here, Dr. Ruth Hussey, as well as the Lord Mayor of Liverpool, a regular. The Metro Mayor of the Liverpool City Region, Steve Rotherham, welcome. Julia Baird, sister of John, and our wonderful honorary president here. We also are privileged to have joining with us our Ukrainians, some Ukrainian friends. The leader of or chair of the Association of Ukrainians in Great Britain, Petro Ruka, welcome. And also local leader, Reverend Dr. Taras Kamich, again a friend and regular visitor here with us. And then too, I'm privileged to welcome the Salvation Army's divisional leader for the Northwest, Major Dr. David Taylor. We welcome all of you and everyone else here. Thank you for coming. Now, we have one gentleman and his wife, Mike and Minnie Pivet-Voz, who I think have traveled the furthest to be here today. They've come from Las Vegas, and Mike is a representative from the Global Peace Initiative who commissioned this monument. And just now, I am gonna invite Mike to come and share a little bit about the Global Peace Initiative as well as the monument. Thank you, Mike.
Thank you, Major. The Global Peace Initiative is a California-based artist coalition that was created in 2003. The mission of GPI is to circle the globe with monuments to peace. These monuments are to be created by young artists, as it is the young who suffer most during war. The first monument was created by a 20-year-old artist named Alexandra Nikita, and it was unveiled in Singapore in 2005. The monument is aptly named Let There Be Peace. The second monument was created by a 17-year-old artist by the name of Lauren Voyers. It was actually unveiled right here in Liverpool in 2010. The monument was created to honor John Lennon. It is named aptly Peace and Harmony. The third monument, which we are unveiling here today, was created by a Mexican artist by the name of Osbelit Garcia-Morales. The worldwide search for a young artist with the capability to create a monument such as this took almost a year. Osbelit is only 16 years old. She comes from a tiny Mexican town with a population of 686. Her town has no art museums or art galleries to help further inspire her artistic curiosity. At 8 years old, rather than playing with her friends, all she wanted to do was draw. She was drawing portraits that were far more sophisticated than what should be expected from an 8-year-old. As she moved on to pastels, word began to spread throughout southern Mexico of an artistic genius. Art supplies were not always available to her. When that was the case, she used boards and flat stones to paint on, and she mixed her own paint using local dyes and chalk. By the time Osbelit reached age 11, she was painting at the level of a master. Local art experts could not comprehend the fact that she had become a master in three artistic disciplines: hyperrealism, surrealism, and abstract. Once she came to the attention of the Global Peace Initiative, we knew that we had found our artist for the Ukrainian Peace Monument. The monument was created to honor the people of Ukraine who, as you know, have been suffering the horrors of war for approximately 15 months since the invasion by Russia. The monument was intended to be placed in the Ukraine, but for obvious reasons, it cannot be placed there at this time. We are extremely grateful to the City of Liverpool and for Strawberry Hill for hosting this unveiling, for safekeeping the monument until it can be moved and rededicated in the Ukraine. We hope and pray that that can happen very soon. In the words of the artist, art's greatest purpose is to serve mankind rather than serve only itself. With this monument, I hope I have created a symbol of peace for Ukraine and mankind everywhere, that peace is the only option. When you see the monument, please pay attention to a couple of things. You can still see, or you can already see, the dove, the book, and the Ukrainian flag as it's being held up high by what I'll call our character. Our character is looking out into the future, looking out into the sky, hoping that peace, as represented by the dove, will soon come over the Ukraine as well as the rest of the world. You'll also see that our character is standing on a globe of the earth. And so he's representing mankind, or is he representing an angel, or is he representing God himself? We'll let you decide that. With all of that said, why don't we go ahead and unveil the monument.
Thank you, Mike. We are indeed very privileged to be the custodians. Custody of this amazing monument. We will look after it before it can begin on its final leg of the journey to Ukraine. So yes, it's time to take a look. I've been praying the veiling won't come off unplanned. Okay, so I'm going to invite the Lord Mayor to come and help me unveil it. And I'd also like to request, if you stay on the side, Councillor, I'd also like to request that the fabulous team, our team and our consultants, as well as the wonderful businessman in Nelson, Manchester, I don't know where it is, but I do know David has been working day and night together with the rest of the team to get the statue ready for today. I'd like them to stand alongside. And I'd also like to invite our Ukrainian friends to come and join me here. And we had a few Ukrainians, refugees, as well as members of the AUGB, who were due here today. So will you all come and stand alongside me as the councillor unveils the monument? And a little bit later, perhaps, you'll get a chance to take a closer look. But just for now, before the Lord Mayor responds, I'm going to invite the Liverpool Signing Choir to come and sign as Jimmy sings for us what we thought was an appropriate song for today, Give Peace a Chance. Thank you.
Yet okay, we've also got fantastic hand clappers for this song, so don't be shy, come out. There you are at the back, Charlie's Angels. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Everybody talk about baggers and saggers and drags, bags, blackers and taggers, and this is a night, ism. All we are saying is give peace a chance. All we are saying is give peace a chance. Everybody talk about ministers, sinisters, banisters, cannabis, bishops and bishops, Popeyes and Popeyes and Popeyes and Popeyes. All we are saying is give peace a chance. It's all the same, folks. All we are saying is give peace a chance. Let me tell you now, everybody talk about revolution, evolution, imagination, modulation, regulation, integration, meditation, United Nations, congratulations. All we are saying is give peace a chance. All we are saying is give peace a chance. Everybody talk about Johnny Yoko, Tim O'Leary, Rosemary, Tommy Smothers, Bobby Dylan, Tommy Cooper, Roland Dale, Derek Taylor, Alan Hinchman, Patricia, Hari Krishna. All we are saying is give peace a chance. All we are saying is give peace a chance. All the same, folks, you can have it tomorrow. All we are saying is give peace a chance. Okay, everyone, sing along. Here we go. All we are saying, come on, let's hear you sing, is give peace a chance. You can go louder.
All we are saying,
come on,
is give peace a chance.
Same. One more time. All we are saying is give peace a chance. Thanks.
Councillor Roy, to come and give a few words in response.
Lord Lieutenant, High Sheriff, Mayor Rotherham, you've bitten him. I think I'd rather come on before these lot rather than after. As the explanation goes, how do you follow that? Give me a round of applause, please. I'll do marvellous to you people. It generally is always a pleasure to visit Strawberry Fields, as I've done on many occasions, but today is extra special, is it not? The city, my city and yours, has got the pleasure to host the Eurovision Song Contest on behalf of a country at war at the moment, which is Ukraine. All we can say to you before going any further is that we will do you proud. If Liverpool does nothing else, it knows how to party. I wasn't sure whether, and they'd finished, whether to should get up and speak or get up and dance. It's just very, very well done. The Peace Monument in itself is a beautiful piece of architecture, but it's what it means, I think, that is important. Whilst the Eurovision Song Contest is going on, it's hoped, and I'm sure it will be, people be signposted to not only come and enjoy the music and the response and the love and respect they'll get from the people of Liverpool, but hopefully to be able to come up here and look at this beautiful monument. And again, as well as hosting for Ukraine, we are the guardians. We will guard this monument until war ends and peace comes to Ukraine. And then at that point, we will have the pleasure, the greatest of pleasure, in handing this monument over to Ukraine so they can remember as a monument that peace is with them, but what they went through beforehand. It is something we want to say every time a war happens, we always say, never let this happen again. And it always does. I'm hoping that one day, along with the words of John Lennon, it will cease and we can have peace. But until that time, we will guard this monument. We will welcome our friends from Ukraine. We will treat them as our guests, as we always do in this city, and we're quite proud of it, and we do it so, so very well. The only thing I would ask, I believe, and I'll admit I'm getting a little bit of a dig in for this, the Peace Monument, when it goes back to Ukraine, I think, as per usual, they always seem to go to the capital cities. Well, as Liverpool, as we always think, is the capital city of England anyway. Well, we know it is, don't we?
Absolutely.
I think it'd be a nice idea that if the Peace Monument went anywhere, it went to Odessa, which is our twin city in Ukraine. So I suppose I'm well out of line saying this, but it's the only chance I get, so I'm making sure I get it in. So thank you to Kathy for today, as usual, as you always do it at Sobody Fields. They put on a great party. I thank you for turning up and for showing our Ukraine friends and, of course, our friends from Las Vegas for the great monument and for the artist that young... I mean, if this is the talent of young people, then we haven't got much to worry about in our future years, have we? Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Councillor. So, give peace a chance. How do we do it in a war torn apart by conflict in Ukraine and lots of other countries? The artist, Osbelit, on the monument you will see as you come a bit closer, suggests four things, four steps, four fundamentals for peace. First, serve, share, forgive, and then dialogue. I think, I don't know if I'm putting words in her mouth, but I think that is her path of peace, those four key elements. And those are sentiments which we hear at Strawberry Field and around the Salvation Army world as we follow in the footsteps of Jesus. We try and do all of those things as we remember that he not only called us to love our enemies and pray for those who persecute us, but also when the peace talks fail, when the dialogue stops, even then we are called to do what without God's grace is impossible to do. We are called to continue to serve the other, to share love with the other, to forgive the other. And right now I'd like Major Dr. David Taylor, who leads the work of the Salvation Army across the Northwest, to come together with Reverend Dr. Taras, who leads the local Ukrainian community here, to come and share some ancient words of scripture that reminds us of the way in which we can know inner peace in a world of conflict as we trust in God and we allow him to make us to find that peace within ourselves. And so, Major David, I almost said David, David is going to read from Psalm 37 in the Good News Translation 1 through to 11, and he's going to do that in English, and then Father Taras will repeat the same verses in Ukrainian. Thank you.
It's helpful to know that many of the Psalms were written in the context of oppression, hostility, and suffering. And they offer words of hope, confidence, and faith in the God who is with us. Psalm 37. Don't be worried on account of the wicked. Don't be jealous of those who do wrong. They will soon disappear like grass that dries up. They will die like plants that wither. Trust in the Lord and do good. Live in the land and be safe. Seek your happiness in the Lord, and he will give you your heart's desire. Give yourself to the Lord, trust in him, and he will help you. He will make your righteousness shine like the noonday sun. Be patient and wait for the Lord to act. Don't be worried about those who prosper or those who succeed in their evil plans. Don't give in to worry or anger. It only leads to trouble. Those who trust in the Lord will possess the land, but the wicked will be driven out. Soon the wicked will disappear. You may look for them, but you won't find them. But the humble will possess the land and enjoy prosperity and peace.
Не розпалюйся гнівом своїм на злочинців. Не май заздрості до беззаконних, бо вони, як та трава, будуть скоро покошені, і, мов та зелена билина, пов'януть. Надійся на Господа і добра чини, землю замешкуй та правди дотримуй. Нехай Господь буде розкіш твоя, і Він сповнить тобі твого серця бажання. На Господа здай свою дорогу, і на нього надію клади, і він зробить, і він випровадить, немов світло, твою справедливість, а правду, немов південь. Жди Господа мовчки, і на нього надійся. Не розпалюйся гнівом на того, хто щасливою чинить свою дорогу, на людину, що виконує задуми злі. Постримайся від гніву і покинь посередця. Не розпалюй лютістю, щоб чинити лиш зло. Бо витяті будуть злочинці, а ті, хто вповає на Господа, землю успадкують. А ще трохи і не буде безбожного, і будеш дивитись на місце його, і не буде його. А покірні вспадкують землю і розкошуватимуть миром великим.
This week, yes, we have a few words from the chair of the Association of Ukrainians in Great Britain, Petro.
Lord Lieutenant, Mayor of Liverpool, Steve as well. It's been an honour and a privilege to be invited here today. And not only on behalf of the Ukrainians in the United Kingdom, but as a board member of the Ukrainian World Congress, I can speak on behalf of the Ukrainians around the world to say a massive thank you to Liverpool, a massive thank you to the people who commissioned and paid for this fantastic, and to the young artist who came up with this image of peace. Ukraine will be victorious, we have no doubt. One day, we say refugees, and it's not a word I really do like, so I say our Ukrainian guests, which are with us at the moment, will be able to go back home to their own country of Ukraine. This statue just encompasses everything about what we all believe in, democracy and peace. This is not just Ukraine's war. This is a war for everyone that believes in freedom and democracy. And Ukraine and the world will be victorious because good will always conquer evil. Thank you to Liverpool being the custodians, specifically Cathy and her team here at Strawberry Fields. Thank you to Liverpool for converting itself into Ukraine for the Eurovision Song Contest, because you have truly stepped up to the mark. And being from Manchester, I have to take my hat off to you on that one. And Andy Burnham can't what a one-upmanship on this one, Steve. You've done a tremendous job. I know I've got many events to attend before the Eurovision final next week, which I won't be at, because I'll be in my own home community of Ashton-under-Lyne, and all our Ukrainian communities up and down the country will be watching this on the big screen. But thank you very much for being the host. Thank you very much for being Ukrainian. And to be fair, for everything this country has done for Ukrainians since the invasion by Russia, thank you will never be enough. We will always be indebted. Glory to Ukraine, glory to its heroes. Slava Ukraini!
Thank you so much. The Liverpool signing choir is still with us, and just now I'm going to invite them to conclude this element of our unveiling ceremony this afternoon. They're going to close with Imagine, and I think they might do a repeat of Give Peace a Chance, for those of you who might like to actually, you know, stand up and join in. When we finished with that, we'd just like to get a photo of the dignitaries at the statue, and then we're going to move swiftly across to the bandstand, where our Mission Development Officer, Major Alistair Fassveld, who's on the team, and he's my better half, as you can imagine from the surname, he will take us through the second half of today's ceremony, and we will be unveiling the bandstand in a few moments. But first, here are the Liverpool Signing Choir, Jimmy Coburn with Imagine.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us only sky. Imagine all the people living. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. And no religion too. Imagine all the people living life in peace. They say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will be as warm. Imagine no possessions. Wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood, a man. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us and the world will live as one. Thank you very much. For this one, aren't you?
Right, as usual with me, very sorry, little bit of a change of plan. Okay, so we're going to do Give Peace a Chance, and as many people as possible. Oh God, I'm too close, aren't I? Come down and sign with us. Jerry, I know you will. You did last time we did it. And then after that, would you mind if we did the Ukraine national anthem? And then everyone can join in that as well. Right? Okay. This is. Right, who's coming down? Roy, come on.
Here we go.
I will!
Sure, Brendan.
I will!
Come on, then.
Come on. Give Peace a Chance. Come on, Brendan. Oh, thank you, Mr. Turtle. Come on. You can hide. This old town is about to clear. I can feel the warmth inside. Is give peace a chance.
Just give peace a chance. It's all the same. You can have it tomorrow. All we are saying is give peace a chance. Okay, everybody at Strawberry Field. All we are saying. Come on.
It's give peace a chance.
It's all the same. We can go louder.
All we are saying.
Is give peace a chance. Brilliant.